Now we will focus on the variables. It means that the total number of items purchased, variables is quantitative. I mean that is a quantitative variables. So we will summarize quantitative data using tables. More specific, a percent frequency distribution. Now we will learn how to construct and then to interpret tabular summarization procedures for quantitative data. We'll focus on the third component of the report. It to summarize the data, the quantitative data. The third component is to construct the percent frequency distribution. For number of item, which is a quantitative variable. First of all, I would like to remind that as defined, frequency distribution is a tabular summary of data showing the number of observation in each of different categories or classes. However, with quantitative data, we must to be careful in defining the different classes to be used in a frequency distribution. For example, consider the data set. Consider the data set, and considering the quantitative variable items. The total number of items purchased for a sample of 100 customers of Vũ Quang Mạnh stores. The three steps necessary to define the classes for a frequency distribution with quantitative data. The first step is to determine the number of different classes. Determine the number of classes. Number of classes will be used to group the data, and as a general guidelines, we recommend using between 5 to 20 classes depending on the data set. For example, for a small number of data items, 5 or 6 or 7 items may be used to summarize the data. But for bigger number of data items, A bigger number of classes are usually required. But remember that the goal, the target, is to use enough classes. To use enough classes to show the variation in the data. To illustrate the variation in the data. And considering the data set, there are 100 clients, 100 customers, so we choose to develop a frequency distribution with 5, 6, or 7 classes. In reality, in practice, the number of classes, should be 5, should be 6, could be 7. In practice, the number of classes is determined by trial and error. And remember that the target is that to use enough classes to illustrate the variation in the data. So the second step in constructing a frequency distribution for quantitative data is to choose a width for the classes. As a general guidelines, we recommend that the width be the same for each class because it's the choices of number of classes and the width of classes are not independent decisions. I mean interrelated. The bigger number of classes means smaller class width and vice versa. So to determine approximate an approximate class width, we begin by identifying the biggest and the smallest data values. Here the smallest data values is 1, right? We begin by identifying the biggest and smallest data values. Then with the desired number of classes specified, we can use the following expression to determine the approximate class width. Approximate class width is the biggest data value minus smallest data value multiplied by number of classes. And we use the round up function in Excel, round up. And identify the biggest data value by the max function. Minus the smallest data value by the mean function in Excel. By member classes, you mean Q50. We enter Fn F4 to fix the range. We copy the cell Q51 to cell QR51. And S51. So, as I mentioned, in practice, determining member classes by trial and error. So, if we choose member classes is 6, so approximate class width is 3. So the upper limit the frequency is a percent frequency. The third step is to determine the class limits. Determine the class limits. Class limits must be chosen so that each data item belongs to one and only one class. The knowest class limit identifies the smallest possible data value assigned to the data. And the upper class limit identifies the largest possible data value assigned to the class with quantitative data such as total number of items purchased in this data set. Class limits are necessary to determine where each data value belongs. Using data of the total number of items purchased in this data set, we chose one item as the lower class limit. As the upper class limit and three items. As the upper class limit for the first class, the upper limit 3. This class is denoted 1, 2, 3 in this table. The smallest data value is 1 is included in the first class, I mean 1, 2, 3 class. To this class. After that, we chose 4 items as the lower class limit, and 6 items as the upper class limit of the second class. 4 items as the lower class limit and 6 items as the upper class limit of the second class. We continue dividing the lower and upper class limit to obtain a total of 6 classes. 1 to 3, 4 to 6, 7 to 9, 10 to 12, 13 to 15, 16 to 18, and the largest data value is 17, is included in the 16 and 18 class, upper class, upper limit, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. Now we construct the frequency distribution. With the first step, choose L 52 to 57, and enter frequency. With the range, and the range. K52 to K57. Control Shift Enter with the Windows system. With the Mac OS system, we use the Control Shift Return for the Mac OS system. Here's the sum. Now we construct a percent frequency distribution by the equation equal L 52 L 58. We fixed L 58 by Fn and F4 together. We copy the cell. Once a frequency distribution is created, Excel chart tools can be used to construct the corresponding histogram. Now I'm going to construct a histogram for the number of items. Histogram for the number of items. So the first step is that choose J 52 to J 57. And then command L52 to L57. For macOS system, for Windows, use control and choose the range. And then click insert. Go to the column. And then choose the cluster in the 2D column. And then right click to format data series. In the series option, graph width adjust to 1%. Click chart title. Replace it with the histogram. For the number of item, access titles, primary horizontal, primaries horizontal, replace access title with number of item with the access titles primary vertical. Here's a frequency. Now we will interpret. Tabular summarization procedures for a number of items purchased. The table 2, here's the table 2, illustrates a frequency distribution for number of item purchased. We mentioned the name of the table first, and we identify the noticeable number. Here you can see that 66 is a noticeable number. So you can set that the majority is, can be the vast majority. I mean that over 50%, the vast majority of customers purchased 1 to 3 items. 66%. So I can repeat, the vast majority of customers purchased 1 to 3 items. I mean 66%. However, 70% of customers was regular customers. So I can conclude that they tended to purchase fewer items
because there was no discount. And 26% of customers purchased between 4 and 6 items. The promotional discount may have encouraged these customers to purchase additional items they would not normally purchase, and only 8% of customers purchased the grouping data. 8%. These 8% customers took full advantage of the promotional discount. I can say that these customers, 8% purchased 7 or more items, took full advantage a promotional discount. Now we will focus summarizing data for two variables using tables. Two variables, twice a customer and net sales. The two variables. Summarizing data for two variables using tables. More specific, a cross tabulation. And we will learn how to construct and then to interpret cross tabulations. Interpret mean that provides a command, describable, compare, and provide any comment on any the similarities and differences. You compare and contrast. Describable, compare and contrast. Now we will practice creating tabular presentation with Excel. Creating the cross tabulation of twice the customer versus net sales. Before constructing the cross tabulation, we will discover what is cross tabulation first. Often a manager is interested in tabular and graphical methods that will help to understand the relationship between two variables. A way to summarize data for two variables. Summarizing data for two variables. And cost tabulation is a method of summarizing the data for two variables. Cost tabulation can be used when one variable is categorical and the other is quantitative, or both variables are categorical. The left and the top margin labels define the classes for the two variables. Now we will construct the cross tabulation. Cross tabulation of twice a customer
versus net sales. And Excel's private table report provides an excellent way to summarize the data for two or more variables. And I will illustrate the use of Excel private table report by illustrating how to develop the cost tabulation of twice a customer versus net sales. For the sample of 100 customers, and in order to use the private table report to create a cost tabulation, we need to perform three tasks. The first task is to display the initial private table field and private table report by three steps. Step one, click insert. And in the table group, here the table group, click the icon above the word private table. Here the word private table, and click the icon above the word private table. The third step is that when the key A, here the key A private table appears, choose the range to the range to the range A1 to D101 to this range. And choose existing worksheet as the location for the private table report. And then click OK. The second task is to set up the private table field. Set up the private table fields. And fields name, customer, twice of customer, item, net sales. And fields may be chosen to represent rows or columns or values in the body of the private table report. Step one, in the private table field, we have to choose fields to add to report and track. Choose twice a customer and track the twice a customer. Track the twice a customer field to the row labels area. To the row. Label areas. And track the net sales field to the column labels area. Right click on the summary net sales and choose field settings. When the private table field appear under the summarize value field by, choose count to count and click OK. And the third task is to finalize the private table report. And to complete the private table report, we need to group the column. We need to group the column representing net sales. And right click to the cell K92. Right click. Right click in the cell K92 and choose group to group. We enter starting at zeros. Starting at zero. We enter zeros for the starting at and ending at 300 and by 25. Click OK.
Now we have a cost tabulation of twice of customers versus net sales. So we will interpret the cost tabulation. First of all, we will compare promotional customer and regular customers in terms of net sales. And you can see that the cost tabulation illustrates that the promotional customers in general, right? Spend more on purchases than regular customers. You can see that? 7, 2, 17, 13, 17, 8, 8, 2, 9, 3, and so on. So I can say that, we can say that examination of cost tabulation of twice of customer versus net sales illustrates that promotional customers in zero spend more on purchases than regular customers. In fact, we provide the details, provide the evidence. In fact, considering net sales ranging from $50 to $75, considering net sales ranging from $50 to $75, the number of promotional customers is 17. Which was much higher, significantly higher than the figure of regular customers. Regular customer with 17 and 8 respectively. And we said that the same pattern could be seen in different net sales ranges. The final component of the report is that to construct and interpret Schrader diagram to explore the relationship between net sales and customer age. Net sales and customer age. It means we summarize data for two variables, using the graphical displays, more specific, Schrader diagram.
To construct a scatter diagram. A scatter diagram. Of customer age and net sales. The first step is to click insert, and the second step is to choose SCADA. In the chat group, and then click the icon above the word select data. And select data source box appear. We choose the data chart data range. And name SCADA. Diagram of customer age versus net sales. X values. X value H. So choose the range. H two to H 101. Y values. In net sales, so the range D2 to D101, and click OK, and click the icon above the word add chart element. Axis titles, choose primary horizontal. Replace the axis title with H. And click the icon axis titles primary vertical. Replace the axis title with net sales. Now we look at figure two. Figure 2 presents a scatter diagram. A scatter diagram of the relationship between customer age and net sales. You can see that the customer range in the age from 20 to approximately 80. Customers range in age from 20 to approximately 80. And you can see that there are more customers in the 25 to 45 age range.
25 to 45 range. There are more customers in the 25 to 45 range, age range. And there do not appear to be a relationship between age and net sales. There doesn't appear to be a relationship between age and net sales. So to summarize this report, unit choice. This report illustrates the results based on a trial promotional campaign. Of customer purchases at Vũ Quang Mạnh stores, when a promotional discount was offered, and appropriate suggestions have been made that the value of promotional discount to sale is the main conclusion. In summary, the customer with promotional discounts spent more on purchases than regular customers. However, based on the number of proprietary car purchases, there were regular customers also using the promotional discount. So this is the end of the chapter 2.